Anatomy of the radial nerve. The radial nerve roots from C5, 6, 7, 8, and T1. That is to say, radial nerve originate from all roots of the brachial plexus, from C5 to T1. Radial nerve begins as one of the two terminal branches of the posterior cord of the brachial plexus in the axilla. It begins in the axilla as one of the two terminal branches and the larger of the two terminal branches of the posterior cord of the brachial plexus. Behind this artery, which is the third part of axillary artery. We all know that the posterior cord of the brachial plexus end by two terminal branches. A smaller terminal branch, which is axillary or circumflex nerve, and the larger branch from the posterior cord is radial nerve. Therefore, the radial nerve begins in the axilla, behind the third part of axillary artery, as the larger of the two terminal branches of the posterior cord of the brachial plexus. What is the course and relation of the radial nerve? The radial nerve descends behind the third part of axillary artery and the upper part of brachial artery. In front of the posterior wall of the axilla, in front of the posterior wall of the axilla, which formed by three muscles, in front of subscapularis, teres major, and latissimus dorsi. Then it descends in front of this head. What is this head from triceps? This is the long head of triceps. Therefore, it passes in front of the three muscles of the posterior of the axilla, subscapularis, teres major, and the latissimus dorsi, which is not present in this drawing, and in front of the third, in front of the long head of triceps. Then it passes behind the middle third of the shaft of the humerus. It passes in the spiral groove with the artery called profunda brachii, which is a branch from brachial artery. The artery and the nerve, profunda brachii and radial nerve, pass to the spiral groove through this triangle, which is called the lower triangular space. Lower triangular space, which lies between long head of triceps, lateral head of triceps, and the muscle passing here, which is teres major. Here, from the axilla, this is a posterior view. This is the back of the scapula and the back of the arm. And the radial nerve with profunda brachii passing in the lower triangular space between long head of triceps, lateral head of triceps, and the teres major. The nerve passes in direct contact with the middle third of the humerus in the spiral groove. And then it passes to the lateral aspect of the arm. It passes from medial to lateral in the spiral groove. In the lateral aspect, it bears this intermuscular septum. It bears the lateral intermuscular septum to reach what? To reach this area. It bears from posterior to anterior the lateral intermuscular septum to appear in the groove between brachialis and brachioradialis. It descends in the groove between brachialis and the brachioradialis to descend to the level of the lateral epicondyle. At the level of the lateral epicondyle, this is the end of radial nerve. It ends here at the level of the lateral epicondyle by dividing into deep terminal muscular branch called posterior interosseous nerve and superficial cutaneous terminal branch called superficial radial nerve. This is the course of radial nerve and the main relation of radial nerve. What is the branches of radial nerve? Branches of radial nerve, first of all, in the axilla. In the axilla, it gives muscular branches. In the axilla, it gives muscular branches. We all know that radial nerve itself and its deep terminal muscular branch, which is posterior interosseous, supplying all muscles of the back of the arm and the forearm. The radial nerve in the axilla supply the long head of triceps. It is the only part of the triceps which originate in the axilla from the infraglenoid tubercle. Therefore, in the axilla, it gives the long head of triceps and it gives a branch called the posterior cutaneous nerve of the arm. Posterior cutaneous nerve of the arm. And from its name, it supply the skin, part of the skin, of the posterior aspect of the arm. Then, in the spiral groove. In the spiral groove, it will supply the lateral and the medial head of triceps. Lateral and the medial head of triceps. The medial head present above the nerve in the spiral groove and the medial head present below the spiral groove. Therefore, in the spiral groove, we will supply the medial and the lateral heads of triceps and anconeus muscle. Here in the spiral groove, it will give nerve supply above to the lateral head and the nerve supply below to the medial head. And nerve supply descend in the medial head to supply the anconeus muscle. This is muscular, cutaneous. Cutaneous in the spiral groove, it gives this branch, which is called posterior cutaneous nerve of the forearm. Posterior cutaneous nerve of the forearm. And it gives this branch. What is this branch? This branch is cutaneous. Called lower lateral cutaneous nerve of the arm. Why lower? because axillary nerve, and by giving the upper lateral cutaneous nerve of the arm and the nerve below supplying the lateral aspect of the arm is the lower lateral. Therefore, please write on this branch lower lateral cutaneous nerve of the arm, and this branch is posterior cutaneous nerve of the forearm, and this branch is to the lateral head, and this branch to the medial head of triceps, and this branch which descend in the medial head downward to supply the anconeus. These are branches in the spiral groove. Then, in this area, it bears the lateral intermuscular septum, appear in the groove between lateral part of brachialis, brachioradialis. Here in this area, it gives muscles. Sure, it gives the lateral part of brachialis. It gives brachioradialis and the extensor carpi radialis longus. Brachioradialis and the extensor carpi radialis longus, because these muscles of the back of the forearm originate in presence of radial nerve itself. Then, at the level of the lateral epicondyle, the radial nerve end by giving deep terminal motor branch, which is called the posterior interosseous nerve. Posterior interosseous nerve is pure motor nerve, actually supplying all muscles of the back of the forearm, except brachioradialis and the extensor carpi radialis longus, which is supplied from the main radial nerve itself before it ends, and anconeus. Therefore, posterior interosseous nerve supplying all muscles, of the back of the forearm, except brachioradialis, extensor carpi radialis longus, and the anconeus. The posterior interosseous nerve, what is the course of the posterior interosseous nerve? The posterior interosseous nerve bears the subinator muscle. And wind around the lateral aspect of radius to appear in the back of the forearm. This is the posterior interosseous deep muscular branch piercing in the floor of the cubital fossa. This is the cubital fossa. In the floor of the cubital fossa, bears subinator muscle, and inside the substance of subinator muscle, it wind around the lateral aspect. This is lateral and this is medial. Wind around the lateral aspect of radius to reach. This is the posterior interosseous, passing in the cut. This is a cut subinator muscle. It appears in the back of the forearm just above the lower border of subinator muscle. Then the posterior interosseous nerve. The posterior interosseous nerve passing between the superficial group and deep group of muscles of the back of the forearm. The extensors in the back of the forearm, there is the superficial group and the deep group. The posterior interosseous nerve appears just above the lower border of submetator. This is submetator, and descend between superficial to it, superficial group, and deep to it is the deep group of the extensors of the back of the forearm. It accompanied in its course in the back of the forearm by artery carrying the same name called posterior interosseous artery. After posterior interosseous, there is terminal branch. This terminal branch, here the main stem of radial, divide into deep muscular, terminal branch, posterior interosseous, and this superficial cutaneous branch, which is called superficial radial. The superficial radial descend in the lateral aspect of the front of the forearm, under cover of brachioradialis. It descend in the lateral aspect of the forearm, under cover of brachioradialis. It becomes very close during descend in the lateral aspect of the forearm. It becomes very close to this artery, which is radial artery. The superficial radial nerve descend very close to the radial artery, and the nerve is lateral to the artery. We should notice that the nerves in the forearm, superficial radial and ulnar nerve, are outer and the peripheral to the arteries, and the arteries passing inside the nerves. This is the superficial radial, outer, lateral, and medial to it is the radial artery. About 5 centimeters above the wrist, the superficial radial nerve wind around the lateral aspect of the forearm to appear in this area. To appear in this area, which is called anatomical snuffbox, where superficial radial nerve terminate by dividing into 5 digital cutaneous branches. This is a famous area which is called the anatomical snuffbox, bounded laterally by the bolus tendons to the thumb. Here there are 3 boluses: abductor bolus longus, extensor bolus brevis, and the extensor bolus longus. Here the superficial radial nerve wind around the lateral aspect of the forearm to reach the back of the forearm in the anatomical snub box, and terminate here by dividing into digital terminal cutaneous branches. These terminal cutaneous branches supplying what? Supplying the dorsal aspect of the lateral 2/3 of the hand. Lateral 2/3 of the dorsum of the hand. And the dorsal aspect of the proximal phalanges. Dorsal aspect of the proximal phalanges. Of the lateral 3.5 fingers. Dorsal aspect of the proximal phalanges of the lateral 3.5 fingers. What is the applied anatomy of radial nerve injury? Radial nerve injury may occur due to compression by crutches or Saturday night paralysis or fracture shaft of humerus or supracondylar fracture of the humerus, which is fracture lower end of the humerus above the medial and lateral condyle. This is called supracondylar fracture. What is the result of radial nerve injury? According to the level. According to the level. If the injury in the axilla. Injury in the axilla leading to paralysis of all muscles supplied by radial nerve. Paralysis of triceps leading to loss of extension of the elbow. And in contrast, the deformity becomes the flexors take the elbow in their direction and the elbow is flexed. Paralysis of supinator muscle leading to pronation of the forearm. Paralysis of extensors of the wrist, leading to wrist drop. And paralysis of extensors of the fingers, leading to finger drop. And this is the famous deformity for radial nerve injury. Flexion of elbow, pronation of forearm, wrist drop, and the finger drop, like this patient. This is the typical position and deformity of radial nerve injury. Flexion of elbow, pronation of forearm, wrist drop, and the finger drop. Sensation. Theoretically, there is a loss of sensation along the area supplied by radial nerve. Theoretically. What is the area supplied by radial nerve? Posterior cutaneous nerve of the arm. Loss of sensation on area of the back of the arm. Posterior cutaneous and the lower lateral. Lower lateral cutaneous nerve of the arm. Loss of sensation over this area. Posterior cutaneous nerve of the forearm. And the terminal digital branches. Superficial radial. Loss of sensation over the lateral two-thirds of the dorsum of the hand and the dorsal aspect of the proximal 3.5 fingers. But this is theoretical. In radial nerve injury, sensory loss is limited to this triangular area on the dorsum of the hand between the first and the second metacarpal bone. This area between first and the second metacarpal bone. Why? Due to overlapping by surrounding cutaneous nerves. Overlapping by surrounding cutaneous nerves, leading to maintenance of sensation on all these areas and sensory loss becomes limited to this area only. Overlapping by other cutaneous nerves like what? Overlapping by lateral cutaneous nerve of the forearm, which encroaching on area of the back of the forearm, supplying the back of the forearm. Medial cutaneous nerve of the forearm, supplying area supplied by radial nerve. And ulnar and median nerve in the hand encroaching on the area supplied by radial nerve. Therefore, the area purely supplied by radial nerve without any overlapping by other surrounding nerves is this area. This the result of radial nerve injury in the axilla. Paralysis of all muscles. Sensory loss in the characteristic area. But if the injury in the spiral groove, injury in the spiral groove, the structures supplied in the axilla is intact, long ahead of triceps, And also in the axilla, there is a branch to the medial head of triceps. Therefore, in the spiral groove, the long head and medial head of triceps are intact, maintaining extension of the elbow. And if the injury is below, in the forearm, no motor manifestation, no paralysis of muscles, no deformity. Why? Because in the forearm, this is injury of the superficial radial nerve with sensory manifestation only. The posterior interosseous nerve is very deep inside supinator, between superficial and deep groove, and no injury of posterior interosseous nerve occurs. Okay, this is the anatomy of the radial nerve and its injury. Thank you for good listening and good luck.